And tonight's education alert, a new president is about to take the reins at Morgan State University. He's Dr. David Wilson, Chancellor of the University of Wisconsin Colleges. But just how will he be received by the students at Morgan State? 11 News education reporter Tim Tooten joins us live in the newsroom with more on that story. Tim.
Well, Donna, based on our visit to the Morgan campus today, Dr. Wilson can expect a warm reception, but one certainly filled with great expectations from the student body and the community.
You could call it the beginning of a new era at Morgan State University, a school rich in history, but very much accustomed to long-term leadership. Its current president, Dr. Earl Richardson, is retiring after 25 years on the job.
So I think it's just a great selection, and I'm looking forward to it.
And so are members of the student body who will attend Morgan State under its first new leader since 1984.
I mean, everybody deserves their fair chance, opportunity, so we're going to see what he can do. No, he got some big shoes to fill.
Dr. Wilson comes to Morgan State with an impressive resume. He's chancellor of the University of Wisconsin Colleges, but has served in a number of administrative roles at Rutgers, Kentucky State, Auburn, Tuskegee, and Radcliffe College. He holds degrees from both Tuskegee and Harvard.
You know, I think it's an opportunity for new ideas and new, you know what I'm saying? It might attract new faces.
New faces and new demands from some students, especially those facing financial challenges.
I would like for them to find some money for non-traditional students like myself who have a nice GPA of 3.7.
More tutoring, we need more book scholarships, we definitely need more materials.
Dr. David Wilson beat out two other finalists for the top job. He'll officially take over the presidency at Morgan on July the 1st, 2010.
Now, coming up new at 6, we'll talk with Morgan State's new president and the school's retiring administrator. That's new at 6. Live in the 11 newsroom, Tim Tooten, WBAL-TV 11 News.